are drinking a ton of wine, but we're also doing something else. Weed. This is Erica. She's a mom who prefers weed over wine, and she gets a lot of shit for it.
I have three kids. It is very tough. It's a lot of work taking care of three kids. After the kids are in bed, I come downstairs with my husband and we smoke. We smoke weed.
Why did you want your face blurred for this interview?
I am a little nervous that, again, I would be judged, my children would be judged, my husband works for a big company. I don't want anything to jeopardize our lifestyle. I don't know if I would say I get shit because no one knows. I just don't tell them, and it's just not talked about. The other day I was at school pickup. A mom was wearing a shirt that says espresso then prosecco, which I thought was pretty cute, but there's no way that I can wear a shirt that says coffee and then weed, or, you know, I'm gonna smoke a joint and then play with my kids. Like, that would never be acceptable.
Right.
I would never ever do that.
How does that make you feel when you see that stuff?
I just am like, okay, that's your medication and this is my medication.
Does smoking weed help you be a better parent and a better mom?
I definitely think that I have more patience. I definitely think that I have less anxiety. Mm-hmm. Instead of yelling, clean up your toys, clean up your toys, let's put on music, let's have a dance party, and it works so much better.
So, you know? Really, the secret to being a parent is getting stoned.
Well, for me, that works. People who smoke are just like everyone else, trying to relax at the end of the day. So whether you do that with a glass of wine, or a whiskey, or taking a bath, or taking a walk, whatever somebody does, everyone has some kind of coping mechanism. And I think just a lot of people, more moms especially, out there are smoking weed because there's no side effects. At the end of the day, I think I'm a really good mom, and I just hate the fact that smoking weed other people might think that I'm not a good mom, because that's the most important thing to me in the whole world.
So how did pot get such a stigma? And who's the one doing the stigmatizing?
I spent all my time researching drugs like Molly, and here you are asking me about weed. How boring.
This is Dr. Joseph Palomar. His research at NYU investigates the stigma associated with recreational drug use.
A major factor women deal with regard to marijuana use is stigma. But women are more likely to stigmatize users. So women have to deal with the stigma from other women. If you're a woman who wants to smoke weed, your main obstacle is other women who disapprove of what you're doing. A lot of people stigmatize marijuana use, particularly older generations. If you were a kid in the 1980s, you were probably taught just say no to all drugs, including weed. In fact, you were probably taught to straight out ostracize marijuana users. We're lacking a drug education here in the US. Anti-marijuana propaganda image from the 1930s or 40s, pretty much everyone depicts a woman that's looking for sex or is vulnerable to sex.
Oh, that energy, beautiful. Let's not waste it dancing.
Yeah, so how do women combat that?
If you're a weed user and you're a millennial, you have a better chance of changing the attitudes of your friends that are your age. It's very unlikely that you're going to be able to change the attitudes of your parents or people much older than you. The stigma is pretty deeply ingrained, and it's not very likely going to change.
I'm just calling because I was curious if you were still, you know, like, selling the greenery, because I'm looking to buy some greenery, so.
You still smoke pot? Oh, Abby.
This is a prank call, bye.
So sad. I know, mommy knows.
You can't have the conversation around cannabis without talking about